This is Mark Williams with Premier Basketball Media, and I'm joined by 2015 Alexa Romano from Albuquerque, New Mexico.
Yes.
You played this summer with New Mexico / Texas Heat.
Yes.
All right. And we're going to add any. Well, you could have done New Mexico / Texas / Colorado.
Oh, Heat. Yeah. Yeah. We actually had no girls from Texas.
At the end of it, you had girls through the summer.
We had two in April, and then they left.
Yeah. But either way, New Mexico, Texas Heat. And you, what high school you go to in Albuquerque?
I go to La Cueva High School.
La Cueva High School. Talk about your experience.
As a high school?
At high school. Yeah. Talk about your high school experience.
So far, it's been good. It's the competition in New Mexico is a little lower.
Mm-hmm.
So it's, I don't know, it's a lot different than club for sure.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Now, share a little bit about your summer with New Mexico, Texas Heat.
I think we had a pretty good summer. We got to travel around the country, so that's a lot of fun.
Yeah.
Play really good teams. And I'm, like, happy but sad that was my last year doing it.
Right.
But I'm glad I did it.
Very cool. Now, how many years? You played quite a few years there with kind of the same group, you and Danny, and playing with Robert?
Mm-hmm. I've known Danny since I was maybe in sixth grade.
Mm-hmm.
And so we just grew up playing together.
Cool.
And I think this is my third year with Robert.
Right.
Yeah.
Talk a little bit about just the special, unique situation of playing with one player, like you said, since 6 years old, and the bond that's been built over years and years and years.
Me and Danny?
Yeah, you and Danny.
Oh, we're really comfortable with each other. Like, we're probably going to be friends for life, close friends. We've been roommates every single summer, or I have with her. And so, the people you meet through basketball is pretty amazing.
Yeah. 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 Coach Bryce is talking about that. People, places.
People, places, principles.
Yeah. And I know there's a fourth P I can't remember. Do you remember?
Pleasure.
Pleasure. There you go. There you go. And he was right about just those people. And that's, you know, a unique situation that a lot of players don't have, mm-hmm. being able to play with somebody, you know, since they were six and going on and on and on and stuff. So
mm-hmm.
that's cool. So you committed to Stanford.
Yes.
Why did you choose Stanford?
I mean, I just felt like it was the best fit for me, and I've realized a lot of people don't really get the opportunity to go there. And then it was more than just a basketball decision, because I knew it would prepare me after with all the opportunities it would offer
Absolutely.
Me. And I couldn't turn it down. It was just once-in-a-lifetime opportunity.
Absolutely.
That a 17-year-old had to make, so it was kind of scary.
Yeah, no, it's funny in recruiting, talk about it all the time, is, you know, your biggest decision before there is, like, what are you going to do on Friday night, and what
yes.
am I going to wear?
Yes,
oh, homecoming dress, and who's going to be my date? And,
and the biggest decision of your life is...
Right,
like,
all of a sudden you're like, yeah.
Yeah,
all of a sudden it's like, oh, well, now you have to pick what university you're going to go play at.
Exactly.
And, you know, all these different reasons, and everybody wants you, and it is a very tough decision. But you're right, Stanford's a great school. Great mm-hmm. school. What do you plan on studying?
I want to minor in Spanish for sure, and then I want to study something that lets me use my language.
Yeah,
like
hola, ¿cómo estás?
Bien, ¿y usted?
But I see.
Maybe cultural anthropology. I'll probably change my major a few times, but I want to do Spanish for sure.
So you talked about something, ultimately you want to do something that will allow you to use your language. What do you think that possibly could be?
I have no idea. I want to experience and travel a lot of countries in the future, even if that means, like, playing overseas. I don't know, but
yeah.
I just want to explore, see
absolutely.
New things.
What's one place that you'd like to see most?
Most?
Yeah, what's the one place? If you go one place in the world.
Oh, gosh.
One place, I know. Tough decisions.
Too many.
Tough decisions.
I honestly want to go to Spain just because I hear they have a very different dialect there, and I just want to hear it.
Right.
And a lot of beautiful cities are there. So.
Yeah. Oh, very cool. Talk a little bit off the court. Well, actually, let's talk this first. I had a question I forgot. What kind of player, what type of player is Stanford getting in you?
They're getting a guard, not necessarily a point guard, but both a point guard and a shooting guard.
A combo guard?
Combo guard, yes. I think, I don't know, I think everyone brings something different to the table mm-hmm. at Stanford, but yet it's still kind of a system.
Yeah.
And I feel like I'll fit in, but also bring something different.
Yeah.
If that makes sense? I don't know.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, you're going to bring in a guard who can break your girl down, who can hit the jumper and get to the elbow, shoot a little pull-up, shoot a floater, bring good length if it's at a point or a wing. And you bring an ability to play multiple positions.
Right.
And that's what a lot of young players don't quite understand is if you can dribble, pass, and shoot, you can play multiple positions and you can defend multiple positions, well, you become a bigger asset,
right?
You know, to your team and your coach. Absolutely. So. More playing time, right?
Right.
Amen to that. So a little bit off the court. What's some things you like to do for fun?
I love dogs, like my dogs. I'm going to miss them so much in college, so I like hanging out with my dogs. I like to read, actually. I'm always reading something. I'm kind of an outdoors girl. I like hiking. I'm really into hot yoga. Like, I feel like, I don't know.
Sweat and stretch all at the same time?
And, like, I go to this gym all the time, and they have, like, workout classes in, like, the hot room.
Yeah.
And I don't know. I think they're so, like, fun and refreshing.
Really?
They're hard, but.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, I've just been into that lately.
I did hot yoga once.
Did you like it?
It was most difficult. It was back in college when I played and, you know, worked out and stuff all the time. It was the most difficult thing I'd ever done.
Really?
I'm, you know, standing and on this pose, and I'm just sweat's just dripping, and I'm like,
I like that feeling, just getting completely drenched.
Yeah.
Yeah. I don't know, but it makes you hydrate.
Oh, absolutely. And it's great to stretch. Great flexibility, and which I never was very flexible. It was awkward. I wish somebody would have videoed it. It would have been really, really funny. So, what kind of dogs you got?
I have a little Chihuahua Yorkie. It's not really mine. It's my mom's. Then I have this mutt. He's like a Schnauzer mix. Found him at a gas station.
Okay.
And he's been the best dog ever. And then I actually brought a dog home without my parents knowing. It was like $20 bucks. So I was like, all right, I'm going to get it. And I got it. And so he's my little mutt, too.
Oh, very
he's
cool.
He's like a small mutt. But
I've had many dogs, and mutts typically seem to be the best.
Yes, that's true.
There you go. All right, last question. What do you hope to achieve in your lifetime?
I'm still trying to figure that out every day, but I want to travel, see new things, and it'd be cool to play for a national championship.
Absolutely.
I'm just learning and finding new things every day to seek, I guess. So
you said travel. You know, you can go down to Antarctica.
Yes, but you have to be a scientist, I think.
No? You can take tours.
I'm not much of a cold person,
so. I don't know. I've always thought it'd be cool to visit all seven continents.
That would be cool.
All right, for the world traveler here, 2015 Alexa Romano, this is Mark Williams with Premier Basketball Report.